This video demonstrates how to work with IFC Types to further enhance BIM-based collaboration workflows between architects and engineers. The conversion process during IFC import and export is controlled by IFC Translators. Users can define and optimize various translators depending on their needs. As part of IFC Translators, it's now possible to create custom IFC type mapping tables as well, which define the conversion between classification systems and IFC types. This video focuses on type mapping and property mapping options to be found in the conversion presets. Other options, including the role of preset lists of the IFC Translator dialog, are presented in other videos. By using type mapping, we can associate classifications with IFC types. There is a type mapping preset in both translators for import and translators for export. In the case of IFC import, type mapping defines how imported IFC elements will be classified in ARCHICAD. This is important because the classification of an element controls which ARCHICAD properties it has. During IFC export, type mapping assigns IFC types to the exported elements based on their ARCHICAD classifications, according to the requirements of the receiving party. Besides type mapping, translators for export also have a preset called property mapping. These two presets are closely tied together. Property mapping assigns IFC properties to elements based on the IFC types they've previously received from the IFC type mapping for export preset. Let's see an example of type mapping for IFC import, and then another example for export. Let's see how to import an IFC file to the ARCHICAD design project. To do this, we must first select an IFC import translator and adjust its type mapping for IFC import preset. In this case, type mapping is created using the classification system. When we import an IFC file, ARCHICAD will not create a new classification system or classification item, but will instead use the data already available for the process. Here we can see various options of how IFC types are associated with classifications when imported to ARCHICAD. Now let's see how type mapping works for IFC export. We select an IFC translator for export and display the type mapping dialog. Here we can specify how to map IFC types for export. We must specify the classification system to be used during the IFC conversion. ARCHICAD provides the freedom to define, edit, and adjust classification systems, the features of which are presented in another video. After selecting the classification system, we can also define the IFC type and IFC product to be associated with the IFC model elements. To do this, we must specify a mapping by classification. We can also use the mapping by element type option. If we use this option, we can't manually define IFC types because ARCHICAD creates an automated data structure to map the elements of the IFC model. Once we're ready with all the type mapping settings, we can continue to define the properties to be added to the elements during IFC export, taking into consideration the requirements of the receiving party. Let's now see how to use property mapping. After selecting an IFC translator for export, we display the property mapping dialog. Let's click on the Map IFC Properties for Export button to edit the content of the selected preset. This mapping functionality enables architects to define and optimize the element mapping table for IFC export. To make sure that only that element information will be included in the export that is required by the receiving party. We can freely associate IFC properties with element types. Property definitions can be extended with additional data using the mapping rules. Mapping rules are explained in another video. Let's see how IFC properties are handled using different presets and translators. We can use the Set Preview button to preview the conversion characteristics of a translator in model view. It is important to note that Preview Translator affects not only the IFC property list, but also the IFC type. Translators work in the following way. First, an IFC type is associated with the elements based on the classification system and through the type mapping. Then, IFC properties are associated with the elements through the property manager based on their IFC type. Here's an example. The general translator is active. Let's have a look at the settings of the IFC mapping. We can see that the slab element is associated with an IFC slab type in the classification file within the classification system. Let's display the property mapping for export settings. The following properties have been associated with the IFC slab type when the mapping rule was applied: name, fire resistance rating, surface spread of flame, and acoustic rating. Let's check how the type mapping and property mapping settings are displayed by the Preview Translator. We can perform a test by selecting an element, for example a terrace slab, in the 3D view. Let's open the settings dialog of the selected element and display the classification and properties panel. The available IFC property lists are defined by the selected translator. The same properties are listed here. The IFC type is also IFC slab, according to the settings. Let's see what happens if we select another translator that uses a different property mapping. We created the test translator earlier. Let's select this, and then use the Set Preview option. This translator uses different property mapping than the general export translator. Let's view the property mapping for IFC export dialog. Test property mapping displays the mapping characteristics of this translator. Here are the IFC slab definitions. The PSET test map is a new IFC property. Previously, we created a custom mapping rule for the structure and for the thickness parameters using the rule content option. By using this option, we can create custom IFC properties for one or more IFC elements. This is extremely useful if we want to fine-tune the quality of the round-trip IFC design data exchange with the engineers. Let's continue and make sure to activate the Set Preview option for the selected translator. Let's display the slab in the 3D view. Let's select a slab and display its settings dialog. Please note that the IFC Properties panel displays the previously defined structure and thickness properties. Using ARCHICAD's versatile property mapping and type mapping functionality enables designers to exchange IFC files according to the strict requirements of the applications used by the engineers. A separate video demonstrates how to export and import property mappings between design projects.